We knew we weren't going to have a long time to build this bridge, so we picked the truss, the town lattice truss, that is one of the quicker ones to fabricate. Well, there'll be over 40,000 board feet of lumber in it, of which probably almost 30,000 is in the truss. That's as much as there is in four or five houses. It's all Douglas fir, except for two pieces of willow, and the willow came from a tree that was cut down across the river here when they were building the abutments. We thought if we're going to cut a large tree down, we might as well use the lumber. So we saw two pieces of willow and put them in as posts. Traditionally, the bridge would have been built out of local materials, pine or spruce or fir and certain local hardwoods, but modern engineers, they don't like to approve buildings made with anything pretty much otherwise than Douglas fir and southern yellow pine, so that's where we end up in western fir. Also, it would have been somewhat hard to come up with as much long material as we got, 24-foot pieces in the eastern part of the country.
We knew that we had to assemble the two large trusses prior to the arrival of the general conference attendees, but we wanted to make everyone feel a part of the construction of these two large trusses. It's a real interesting approach to timber framing to do this kind of work, but we thought we'd let everybody at least have the opportunity to drive one peg when they arrive on site. So when people registered at the conference, they were given a peg to be signed and then driven, and I think it's worked out very well to give people a sense of participation. It starts to build the momentum that we really need to pull this project off.
Spinning, is it?
Pulling and being able to guide this thing up as we go. Then we need people spread down the length of the truss until it's as full as we can get it. Still be functional there, not too close. The procedure we'd like to use is having someone standing ready with a short blue pipe point up just behind the people that are lifting. So as soon as possible, they can just come in and they're not carrying the pike as they're walking with the chance of hurting somebody. So the people that are doing the lifting, we're going to go about 5 feet. The orange ones are going to take at least two, but preferably three people to manhandle. When we get close to the top, we'll call people off. The people in the block of tackle will essentially have control at that point, and we can just let it come up. We are going to let it rest against the derrick at the final position for the lift.
Do you need people to stay quiet?
I would prefer that we stay quiet at all times.
Somebody on
please respond with A-A-Y-E. Rope, ready?
Hey!
Mike, ready?
Hey!
Lifter, ready?
Hey!
Yo, hey!
Get out of there!
Keep out from underneath that!
Three! Four! 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 Four!
gun. Drop it. Point, left your points.
Got it.
Take
that right off.
Everybody, shh. Listen up. Rotate, just tip them, just rotate them straight on over. Watch your head.
Well, let's just say I was awake at the time.
Sitting there waiting for the fire.
Earlier today, a bunch of fourth graders came and we wanted us to give a talk about what we were doing. And one of the questions that they asked was, how much are we getting paid to do this work? Of course, I laughed a little bit and I said, well, to tell you the truth, we're getting paid a lot, but not in money. Most of what's going on here today is with volunteers. And as an organizer of the volunteers, I got to tell you that it's been a thrill. I put out the word about 6-8 weeks ago that we were going to be here 4 weeks early working on this bridge. And anybody wanted to give up a whole week of their time for no money and maybe a little food and hard bench to sleep on should call me right away. Well, the phone started ringing off the hook. We got plenty of people. So 3 weeks ago today, the first contingent showed up. And we started laying out these trusses. There was just too much of the work that is sequential and repetitious for it all to be done in this 1 week. So we first started laying out the trusses of the town lattice part of the trusses. And 14 people were here. We worked long hours. And our pay was all the knowledge we're getting and an awful lot of fun between us. At the end of that week, I felt like I earned 14 new friends. Next week, same thing happened. Fewer people, about 10 people were here. And then the last week, I think about 8 people were here. If it weren't for those people, we would have never gotten into where we are right now. So in telling those fourth graders today how much we got paid, well, there's a whole lot of pay here.
That rope needs to be flipped so that when they pull it through the shiv, it doesn't come from underneath.
Yeah.
Hey, it's right here.
There, these guys right here.
Jan!
Okay, squid.
He's having a good time.
Everybody squid. I'm going to truss up, but I'm smiling. Should we wave?
Same response as last time, so we know we're all ready. Rope, ready!
I wasn't,
the dovetail on it wasn't.
They're going to want to come in anyway as soon as you start to pull that weight off.
No, it's not tight enough, it won't pull up.
Lift it!
Lift!
Oh! Oh! Easy! Easy! Have it low!
That's moving.
Yes, walking. 10 inches. Hey. Stop!
Hold on.
How much power are we feeling?
You ready, Jen?
Yep.
You're going to come south and don't get a little attention.
Is there a reason that you picked it up?
Give it a hit.
Move!
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 Who's nice? This guy looks just like mine.
9 7/8.
It's a 120-foot clearspan, town lattice-covered bridge. The overall length is 132 feet on the bottom and 144 feet on the top. And we were consuming about, including, I think this is including roofing, flooring, and everything, about 50,000 board feet of lumber, most of which came from British Columbia. And the bridge, one of the trusses that we lifted yesterday weighs about 40,000 pounds. At its present moisture content, and the bridge entire weighs somewhere around 145,000 pounds.
Okay, I got it.
Let me go in there.
Yeah, I'll hold it. Do we roll this up once it's in? Barely, huh?
Okay.
Straight in, right?
Yeah.
In consultation with Jan Lewandowski, the professional bridge builder that's a member of our guild, he felt that it was possible to raise the two large town lattices by hand, but to the best of his knowledge, it had never been done before. We started to calculate the weight of each of these two individual trusses, and we realized that it exceeded 40,000 pounds as far as we could tell, and we felt that we needed some sort of a mechanism, an assist to ensure the safety of the guild members that were lifting the truss, and a way and means of spacing the two trusses once they were erected to stabilize them. So we came up with the idea of the derrick arrangement and using the large sets of block and tackle. And as it turned out, when you calculate the lifting capacity of those block and tackle, they functionally could have lifted the trusses pretty well on their own, although the first few feet of the lift are crucial, and that's where the many members of the guild that we had spread across those trusses lifting, and then the pike poles contributed to the success of raising them. It was a pretty exciting thing. We'd never really, we don't think that in North America anything that large, an assembly of timber like that had ever been lifted by hand in recent history at least.
These two must have measured.
Yeah. Sir, the one here I have just there. These two I got on template, that's no problem. Thank you.
Get the bed timbers straightened out, crib and shim those, and we'll put it back in the bed timbers and everything.
Well, the project was originally proposed in May of 1991 to the city, and even with slightly more than a year's time to prepare, it took all of that year and considerable amount of time and effort to pull it off. We had budgets to have approved by city council. We had a design to develop for the bridge itself, materials to source, permits to apply for from conservation authorities, Ministry of Natural Resources, that kind of thing. And we really needed some time actually prior to the conference in Guelph to assemble some of the large sections of the bridge, the two main lattice trusses, the two sides, to allow the short construction time during the conference.
Everybody get back!
We'll tap them.
We're just going to tap them.
Yeah.
Got it, John.
John,
John
Gary's got enough height.
What?
Got enough height.
I want you to listen to me.
It hasn't ever occurred to me to call the office.
Okay, so all these team leaders here, Mike Salmon and these 15 people.
Meet over by the strapping.
Meet over by the strapping. Okay, roofing. Here we go. Yeah, I need about 200 people, so don't go anywhere. What we're going to have to do first is we're going to get a small group and we're going to move the scaffold as soon as I think the trusses are done. We're going to start putting up scaffolding. The X-bracing, Nancy Wilkes is in charge of that. I think they're pretty well under control.
You need half a dozen riggers.
Yo, Heath!
You need half a dozen riggers.
Shakers!
Hey, Bruce!
You need half a dozen riggers.
Half a dozen riggers, right here.
Can you give me a shaker?
£8,000 here is about 2,000 pounds in here, and so after you're 40 pounds per person, that's a good put. But 50 pounds, we can handle some more stuff.
Are the pollers ready?
Aye!
Okay, let's give it a nice easy tension. Nice and easy. Legitimate shot. We got it. We need to find this out before too much long. We need to find out whether we can do this, because if we can't, we need to find alternative methods, and we'll be discussing. So does everybody understand the three moves? One, we're going to pull it with a blocking tackle. Two, we're going to take our picture. Three, we're going to try and give it a push, and then we're going to go to dinner. Is everybody ready? Okay, please reassume the position you had before as much as possible. Are the rollers ready? Give me an eye. Are the pullers ready? Give me an eye. All right, give me some tension. Nice and easy.
Easy.
Be quiet, I need you to forward. Keep on coming, straighten her out. Nice and easy. Good job. You're earning
your
roller
your square, it's running good.
Okay.
Did you feel anything?
Move it back a little.
Have our picture taken with the classic panorama camera.
Folks over here, you might as well get in the picture. Anywhere on the one we put in the bridge, you might as well get in it.
Come on, Laura!
Here we go, everybody find a spot. Camera's going.
Are the rollers clear of well-meaning pushers?
Right rear is okay.
Left rear.
Good.
We're okay?
Yeah! Yeah! This past week, and in the volunteer weeks previous, I've been most impressed with the resourcefulness and skills of my colleagues. I think that's really the heart and soul of the Guild. We've made some remarkable progress just in terms of raw work, but also we've modified the design and I think improved it, made it simpler to build and stronger in the long run and more durable as well. And none of those improvements and enhancements and small miracles grew out of a vacuum. They all started with the people on the site and became a blend of their skills and experiences throughout.
Put a white veil on her,
and
we're trying to find the minister. And she said,
"Someone
can marry her, but they definitely aren't getting
the shingles." And the shake heads know what they are. Make sure you use 100-core shingles for the first box. Nails go in third. Wherever the width of the shake is, divide it into three. That's where the nails go.
The bridge itself weighed approximately 148,000 pounds when it was finally lifted. We did move it prior to that when not quite as much of the roof system was built, so it was a little bit lighter. It was done on wooden rollers on a heavy bed of timbers, and that allowed the momentum, the simple forces of block and tackle and literally pushing the bridge to move it that first 100 feet.
We're going to do it on three. We need to stop this thing. We get it going, we're going to give the command. 4 feet only. And then we want the wedges and the rollers. It may want to keep going, so put the brake on this thing.
Which way are we pushing?
There's a bit of a hill uphill here. We don't want it to go too fast, so it's going to take a bit of a push. Everybody ready on three? Yeah. One, two, three! Yeah. Nice and easy! Easy! Easy!
For you to say.
Oh.
One more foot!
One more foot!
Come on!
Hold! Just hold!
Going with the command.
One more foot forward.
Yeah.
On three.
On three. We need quiet on the whole project. Everybody quiet. Back roller crews ready?
Aye.
Front roller crews ready?
Aye.
On three. One, two, three. Steady.
The process in the past typically was to move it on rollers all the way across the river and then gently lower it down onto the support piers in the river. In this case, with some labor laws that would needed to be dealt with, some local concerns about conservation issues in working in the river and so on, we ended up using two large cranes to do the final pick, to actually pick the bridge up and set it into place. So it was a bit of a mix of traditional technology for moving bridges coupled with, you know, some pretty high-tech lifting techniques with these two large hydraulic cranes that were brought in.
We gotta go in.
Okay, guys, with that cheese,
we're running out of people.
The whole damn thing myself. Yep, got her here, boys. Y'all right over there? I got her here.
Rollers. You handed them.
About seven.
Hey, everyone, get ready.
I don't know how many people. Hey,
arm up, ready?
Ready!
The other one ready to go?
chainsaw here.
The bridge was actually strengthened in the lifting locations to prevent any structural damage to it, because so much of the weight is then borne in two specific spots.
Event, but if you worked on it, it's a once in four lifetimes.
Let's do it.
Proud. Impressed with this whole group. We just had a religious experience. We raised a bridge.
It's great. It's wonderful.
We'll go along. One guy sawing, one guy throwing the pieces in a garbage bag, okay?
I know there's 30, 50 safety belts on this site, and we could use every single person. I've got an extra.
Okay.
For instance.
Every two or three years, the Guild tends to get involved in a fairly large project, and it was about 2 years ago we decided that this year, in Guelph, as it turned out, that we would tackle another large project, and it was back in May of 1991 that we proposed that we'd build this town lattice covered bridge for the city. It was something that was well received by that group. They had always wanted a bridge to link that part of the city together, and it's a gift that we're giving to the city of our labor and our love for our craft, and sort of a sharing of one community with another of a token of lasting pleasure and function for the city of Guelph. As it turns out, it's fun to work together with people from all over North America and beyond in these large projects, and I think the Guild will continue, because they've been so successful, to do this kind of thing in the future. The City of Guelph really pulled together, and they had a lot of volunteer help and contributions from various groups and individuals to make it work. So it wasn't just the Guild's giving, it was a really widespread community effort on both sides.
What do you think, Bruce?
Ago, when their two members from the Timber Framers Guild came to my office, and they said, next year we're going to have a conference in Guelph,
And part of the conference, we would like to take on a project. We would like to do something for Guelph. When we went through a number of different projects, I looked at the city map, and I saw down at the end we had the junction of the Speed and the Iremosa River where we are now. And I said to them, you know, it would be nice if we could put a bridge across here, because our walkway system sort of ends east and west, and people can look across, but they can't walk across. Well, the project just kept on getting better and bigger. Of course, with any project, there's a lot of costs involved. There's a lot of lumber here that had to be bought. I think council supported something that's going to be here for the history of Guelph forever and ever. We thank all the agencies, the companies, the engineers, the volunteers, the community groups, the businesses, the local clubs, the staff from Recreation Parks Department, and all the volunteers that worked so hard over this last period of time to get us to where we are today. Your acting worship, timber framers, ladies and gentlemen, we thank every one of you for your support. But I would like this crowd to give a special thanks for those people that worked so hard, the timber framers, in putting this together. We thank you from the bottom of our hearts.
It gives me great pleasure to share in this historic event, and I'm sure that you will agree that this addition of the Town Lattice Bridge will enhance our fair city. And it was really amazing to see such a large group of people from different parts of the country all come together to work on one project with such dedication, such spirit, and such efficiency. You brought something so special to our city.
I'm going to ask Scott Murray to bring some greetings on behalf of the timber framers and thanks.
It was just about a year ago that I stopped in this playing field at about 3 in the morning on the way home from our last conference in New York. I could sense the energy. I just knew we could do it. I'm proud to be a timber framer, and I'm proud to have had this chance to lead this group, to make a difference in this world that we live in, and to leave something for the city and for the citizens of Guelph for us to be remembered by after coming here this year with our conference. It's been an excellent opportunity to come to Canada. I feel now it's truly a North American guild. And I just want to thank every single one of you who have made it possible. There's a lot of time and effort have been spent on this project, but it's still been more fun than I can ever remember. You've all made it possible. I want to say thanks to you. I'm proud to be a timber framer.
On behalf of the Timber Framers Guild of North America, I'd like to dedicate this Town Lattice Covered Bridge to the city and citizens of Guelph, Ontario.
Thank you.
we have there?
Scott.
This evening, we have the opportunity of being witnesses, and by being witnesses, being a part of the covenant by which they celebrate their union. I would like to ask you that for the next few moments, this place in which we're gathered is essentially a chapel. This bridge, thanks to your hard work, was built to last, and it is one of the marks of marriage that it is built to last and to be one of the things which endures.
Not long ago, I stood alone, faced each new day by myself. Then you came and taught me beauty, gave meaning to my hopes. Let me share your dreams for tomorrow. In a house in the country would be just fine. You and I by the fire just enjoying the time. Our children asleep beneath the northern lights. Living in our love, would life be so right? Well, this house in the country would be my life if you'd come with me, my lady, and be my wife. Yes, if you'd come with me, my lady, and be my wife.
Who presents this woman to be married to this man?
On behalf of all these loving friends and all timber framers, we do.
And who presents this man to be married to this woman?
We all do.
Perfect. I, Jim, take you, Vicky,
to be my wife.
To be my wife.
I, Vicky, take you, Jim.
I, Vicky, take you, Jim.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
Jim, Leroy, and Vicky Jones have made this solemn covenant, and in the eyes of God and before you, their community, are joined. Please join me in welcoming them.
Thank you.
Knees up now. Both sides evenly, please. Are the pullers ready? Alright, give me some tension. Nice and easy. Looking a lot better.
We have a quarter inch gap between all shingles and shakes, okay?